And welcome to Heart of a Halfling, where we're going to talk about Lord of the Rings and a little bit about D&D. So if that sounds good to you, come on. So, first video. Don't know if anybody's going to watch. Don't know if anybody cares. And that's okay. If you like it, cool. I guess like it. But if not, that's okay too. I really just want to talk about Lord of the Rings. I love it. When the movies first came out, it became very quickly a Christmas tradition because they came out like yearly at Christmas, and so they became Christmas movies to to my family, me, and yeah, that was, oh my gosh, that was in 2000. I'm aging myself, but it's cool. And yeah, I remember my dad talking about the books, and you know, when he was younger, I actually have one of them right here, like, he had the books. They were really, really worn and well-loved. I think when I was about 13, 14 years old, he passed the books down to me. And I was really into Chronicles of Narnia at the time. And so I didn't really look into Lord of the Rings outside of the movies until just a few years ago. In 2018, I was pregnant. And, you know, they tell you, like, you should read to your baby so they get to know your voice. And I was like, why not? I got time. I'll read Lord of the Rings. And so I started reading them, fell in love with them, and thought, like, I've been missing out this whole time. So now, that was 3 years ago. Now, my poor husband, I've decorated, like, most of the house with Lord of the Rings memorabilia or things that I've made that kind of feel Lord of the Rings or whatever. There's just something about the books. It just feels warm and cozy, which is weird because it's actually, I mean, it's an adventure story. Like, you know, The Hobbit's very much so an adventure story. And then the trilogy, it's an adventure story, but it's about good conquering evil. And so it is like a very solemn story. Like it has a heartwarming ending, but it's still very solemn. And I think when you read The Lord of the Rings, you can feel Tolkien's view on war, really. And yeah, it's just, I just really enjoy them. When I read them, it just feels like fall. So every, like, August, September, I'll reread the books now, and for sure, make sure I reread the books then. I'll reread the books throughout the year, but for sure at that point. And then my husband bought me this cookbook that is nothing but, like, Middle Earth themed foods. Oh, it's so good. It's so good. And for so many of the recipes to, like, require, like, flour or potatoes, like, things that I would normally think are, like, heavy and starchy and, like, don't you eat too many of those. Oh my goodness, I've lost weight on this, and this is the only way we've been eating. My favorite thing, and I promise, even if nobody watches this, I will still do it. I will do a video making pork pies. They're so good. So good. They're my favorite thing. Pork pies and the West Farthing Fairings, which are just like spice cookies. Oh, makes the house smell like Christmas, and I love it. And just since I'm just talking, my husband bought me this for our 5-year anniversary, which is wood, and I bought him a really cool D&D box, and he bought me this amazing hobbit pipe, and I love it. It's, he comes home and I'm just sitting on the couch like, pop, 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 like, and it's totally usable. I'll see if you can hear it. I guess if you smoke something, you could probably actually smoke out of this, but I have no intention to. I'm not a smoker. I just think it's so freaking cool. And just because my husband loves me and spoils me, like,
At some point, I'll have to do, like, a mini tour of the house, because I've done several, like, Lord of the Ring artwork. None of it's, like, super amazing, but it's good enough for us. So I've got Lord of the Ring artwork. Ooh, I've got a Hobbit shower curtain. I love it. Just, it makes me so happy. But he recently bought me this amazing mug from Etsy. So it's wood. Like, the guy carved it, like, smells like the sealant or the beeswax or whatever, and then it has like a stainless steel inside, and like, look at that, it's amazing. Oh, I love it. And then on the back there's a little carving, a little hard to tell, but it says, "If more of us valued food and cheer and song above hoarded gold, it would be a merrier world." And I love it. It only holds my water. I only drink water, and occasionally Sprite if I'm feeling quite festive. But otherwise, it's just water, and I don't care that I have this giant 20-ounce mug just from, I feel cool, and I take it everywhere. Like, it's gone to many, many family gatherings just because I want to show it off. It's so cool. Oh, I love it. I think what my plan is for this channel, outside of just nerding out and showing off all my cool stuff, my plan for the channel is to go through the books, and I know, like, a lot of channels on Lord of the Rings does this. Cool, go watch them, they're all great. But I kind of want to go through the Silmarillion. Like, I've never, I've tried going through it a little bit, but I never fully finish it, and was thinking one day, like, hey, let's do a channel. Everybody else does. I'll have a channel, and I'll talk about the Silmarillion, and I thought I can just go chapter by chapter, give my thoughts on it, kind of talk about it, and yeah. I thought, too, we could do some baking, do some cooking. I've got to show you the pork pies. They're just, I got to show you those at least. And then I also like to sew, and I have this really nerdy desire that, my poor husband, I want to dress like a hobbit. So but I only wear dresses, not for any sort of, like, religious purposes. It's because I hate jeans. I hate them. There's no pockets, first off. No pockets. I made a dress right now. It's kind of like a skirt. The pockets that I'm wearing, I can put my Hobbit book in there. I can put my daughter's, sippy cup in, like, the same pocket, while the other pocket has my phone and keys and her snacks in them. Those are pockets. Whatever they put on jeans now, those aren't pockets. It's just capitalism trying to get you to buy more purses. Anyways. So I want to make Hobbit clothes. Again, just dresses, because that's all I wear. Again, no religious purposes. Just, I hate jeans. It's just a thing. So I bought a pattern that lets you, like, it shows you how to make a corset, and the skirt, and the apron, and, like, a little, like, neck scarf. So, I'm sure if any guys are watching this, they're like, I don't care about that. Then just skip those videos, and we'll talk about the books on the next video. It's cool. I really just want to talk Lord of the Rings on a very casual basis, and I want to learn more about it, and if you have suggestions or questions or whatever, drop them in the comments. Let me know. I just want to be a hobbit. That's it. For copyright reasons, this is Heart of a Halfling, okay? Oh yeah, and we will be talking about D&D a little bit. Not quite as much as we talk about Lord of the Rings. My husband is way more informed about T&D than I am. In fact, I'm in the game room right now.
And so we'll talk about D&D just a little bit, just here and there, but not to the same amount that we'll talk about Lord of the Rings. That's what I really want to focus on, is Lord of the Rings. So if that sounds interesting to you guys, awesome. Like the video, comment, you know, appease the algorithm, YouTube gods, and let's do this. Let's just have fun, and let's not watch our feet and go on a journey. Let them carry us to an adventure. And may the hair on your toes never fall out.